So now let's start thinking about what are good features that we can find between two images of the similar scene or a same object that we can then use to be able to register that same feature across two different images. I'm going to use this simple object of a water bottle to help us illustrate this. So as I've said before, we're interested in extracting features. Basically, we want to find parts of an image that lets us encode that image in a compact form so then I can do comparisons from one image to the other. I'm going to propose the concept of edges here. Edges on an image in a variety of ways basically could be one way of encoding such an information. So what kinds of information do we want to look at? Basically, what we want to look for is various forms of discontinuities in an image or a scene, and that basically is one of the ways to think about what an edge is. So an edge in an image basically is trying to capture the discontinuity in a scene and use that to be able to then find information that would be, again, somewhat repeatable across images. We'll look at these more in detail. So let's look at, for example, this water bottle and see what kind of changes in the scene we could actually look for and actually look for certain discontinuities in this. So for example, at the water bottle on the top of it, you basically, if I was to start drawing surface normals, you would basically see the surface normals going this way. And after a while, there are no more surface normals because they're on the other side. So this form of discontinuity, if there was a sudden change in it, would allow us to start thinking about how we could actually look for discontinuities of this form in surface normals. So those would be surface normal discontinuities. Let's look at depth discontinuities. In this case, of course, we know there's an object. Of course, it might be in front of something. So by just being able to look at the sides here, you know that anything behind that would be at a different depth. This would be in front of everything behind that. So that would be a depth discontinuity. How can we actually look at the term water here and be able to separate it out? Well, in this case, if you can notice, is water is written with a different color than the background. So surface color is basically also a cue, a discontinuity that we can look at that basically points out how we can actually separate out terms like water or even this band here, or in fact, even looking at how we can take difference between the bottle and the cap here. Another form of discontinuity is illumination. This object, of course, is being lit in different ways, and of course, it creates a shadow, or it could actually have other types of reflections and specularities and stuff like that that are also coming in because of the lighting conditions on it. That basically is referring to discontinuities because of lighting changes and such on the object. So hopefully you see now that by just looking at various types of discontinuities, we can start extracting some information about an image. So of course, what we now want to do is go back to the image itself and look for certain sets of discontinuities that would basically best capture the changes because of the normals, the depth, surface color and illumination. Of course, that is a rather big problem and we should be looking at it. And this is one of the bigger things we look at in computer vision when we do analysis of scenes. Now, one thing I wanted to emphasize here, this is an extremely important concept. The edges basically are encoding change in a spatial way of looking at an image. Anywhere I traverse, I look for a change, and that change encodes a lot of information. And in fact, some may argue that this is a very important set of information about an image. So in an information theoretic manner, what we can actually say that edges and basically are encoding change, and therefore are an efficient way to encode an image. So basically, anytime I can think about an image, if I can start looking at where the changes are, that basically starts giving me a lot of information about what the image would be, because now I've actually taken a differential code to represent an image. Wherever there are changes, I'm going to highlight those. We'll look at that a little bit more carefully in a bit.